Three capacitors, 1 microfarad, 2 microfarad and 3 microfarad are connected in series across 15 volt supply as shown in figure. Find VA minus VB. And there are options also and there is a diagram. For solving this, you need to know two equations. If the capacitors are in series connection, the equation is 1 by C equivalent equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. If it is in parallel connection, the equation is C equivalent equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. These two equations you have to know. The second thing is, if the capacitors are in parallel connection, the voltage will be same. Here the voltage will be V, here the voltage will be V. And the charge will be different. Q1, it will be Q2. If it is in series connection, the voltage will be different. It is V1, it will be V2, the charge will be same. Okay, the charge will be same. And you need to know the equation which is relating Q, C and V, that is Q equal to CV. Okay, if we know all these things, then you can solve all the problems. And the second thing you need to know is how to simplify the circuit. Here it is in series connection. If it is in series connection, the effective capacitance will be 1 by Ceq equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3. Here you can see that 1 microfarad, 2 microfarad, 3 microfarad. From here we can write 1 by C equivalent equal to 6 is the LCM here. So it will be 6 plus 3 plus 2. So 1 by C equivalent will be 11 by 6, right? So C equivalent will be 6 by 11. So here the C equivalent is 6 by 11. Here what we need to find? We need to find the potential difference across these 2 microfarad. Here we know that the potential difference will be different because it is series connection. Here it will be V1, here it will be V2, here it will be V3. We need to find V2, right? So we can write the equation for V2. The equation for V2 will be, charges are same because it is series connection. In series connection, charges will be same. Okay, so here we can write the charge is Q here, here the charge is Q, here the charge is Q. The equation for V2, we need to find the V2 here. The equation for V2 will be Q by C2, right? Second capacitance, so we are taking it is C2. Okay, but Q is same. We need to find that Q. What is equation for Q? Q is CV. Here we need to find C equivalent into V, right? So Q equal to C equivalent is 6 by 11 into V is 15 volt. Okay, so Q will be equal to 90 by 11 micro coulomb. So everywhere here charge is Q, everywhere it will be 90 by 11 micro coulomb. Now what we need to find here? We need to find V2, right? Potential difference across these 2 microfarad capacitor, VA minus VB. For that we are using this equation, V2 equal to Q by C2. What is the value of Q? Q is same everywhere. So 90 by 11 all divided by C2 is 2, right? So if I am taking the multiplicative inverse, we can do one thing, 90 by 11 into 2. 2 and 2 will cancel, it will be 45, then V2 is equal to 45 by 11 volt. Okay, so we got the answer, it is 45 by 11. As shown in figure, a potential drop 40 volt is applied across CD. The energy stored in 3 microfarad capacitor is dash. Here we need to find the energy stored in this 3 microfarad capacitor. You need to know two equations here. If the capacitors are in parallel connection, the effective capacitance Ceq is equal to C1 plus C2. If the capacitors are in series connection, the effective capacitance Ceq, 1 by Ceq equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. Okay, you need to know the equation for Q, Q is equal to CV. And if the capacitors are in parallel connection, the charge will be different. It is Q1, it is Q2 and voltage will be same, V and V. If the capacitors are in series connection, charge is same, Q and Q, voltage will be different. You need to know all these things to solve this kind of numerical. Okay, and you need to know how to simplify it. For that, you need to identify the series connection and parallel connection in the circuit. Here I am going to observe this circuit. Here you can see that this is 40 volt. This is 40 volt here. It will be 0 volt here. Okay. From here you can see a splitting, right? From here you can see a splitting. So from here, this 2 microfarad, 3 microfarad, 2 microfarad, all these capacitors are in series, and this 4 microfarad, it is in parallel with these 3 capacitors. So let us redraw the circuit. Okay. This is C. This is C, right? The point C, and from here it is 2 microfarad, 3 microfarad, then 2 microfarad. So it is 2 microfarad, 3 microfarad, and 2 microfarad. Okay, then after that, from here it is 4 microfarad. So we have simplified the circuit. It is 4 microfarad. What we need to find here? We need to find the energy stored in the capacitor 3 microfarad. So energy stored in the capacitor 3 microfarad. Okay, energy stored in the capacitor 3 microfarad. The equation is half CV square. That is equation, is equal to energy. But we don't know the value of V. Okay, we know that here the value will be V1. Here the value will be V2. Here the value will be V3. But we need to find that value V2. Then only we can find this energy. For that, we are going to simplify the circuit. For that, we need this Q, right? Q will be same everywhere. We need this Q. Then only we can find this half CV square. We can find this V2 using this Q. Then only we can find the energy stored in the capacitor. So for that, we are finding the total charge first. What is the total charge in this circuit? For that, we need to find the effective resistance. This is the equivalent circuit. Okay. And I am going to draw the second equivalent circuit. This is series connection, right? If it is series connection, how to find the effective capacitance? Yes, 1 by Ceq equal to 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 2. Okay, 1 by Ceq equal to, the LCM is 6 and it will be 3 plus 2 plus 3. Which is equal to 8. So from here we can write Ceq equal to 6 by 8 is equal to 3 by 4 equal to 0.5 microfarad. Okay, so we got the effective capacitance of these 3 capacitor. I can redraw the circuit again. Okay, this is 0.75 microfarad, which is equal to all these circuit, all these capacitors. Again, we have one more capacitor here. Okay, we have one more capacitor. This is 4 microfarad. So this is the equivalent circuit for this one. The effective capacitance is 0.7 microfarad. Okay, so this 0.75 microfarad is equivalent to these 3 capacitors. This is connected to a 40 volt source, right? Which is connected to a 40 volt source. Now we are going to find the charge here. We know that here the charge will be Q1, here the charge will be Q2, because it is parallel connection. In parallel connection, charges are different. Okay, so I am going to find Q1 here. We need the value of Q1. Q1 equal to, the equation is C into V. What is C here? It is 0.75. 0.75 into 40, which is equal to 30 micro coulomb, right? So we got the charge here. Total charge is 30 micro coulomb, and this capacitance is equivalent to these 3 capacitance. So all these capacitors are having same charge, 30 micro coulomb, because it is in series connection. The total equivalent capacitance is 0.75, which is equal to these 3. So total charge in this capacitor, it is 30 micro coulomb. It is in series connection, so it will be, here it will be 30 micro coulomb, here it will be 30 micro coulomb, here also it will be 30 micro coulomb. Everywhere it is 30 micro coulomb. What we need to find here? We need to find the energy stored in this capacitor. Okay, for that, what we need? We need V2. What is the equation for V2? V2 is equal to Q by C. What is the value? It is Q1. What is value here? It is 30. right? What is the value of this capacitance? It is 3 microfarad. So we got 10 volt. That is a voltage. Now using this voltage, we can find the energy. Energy will be equal to half into C. What is the value of C? It is 3 microfarad, right? 3 into V square is 10 square, which is equal to E equal to, we can cancel this one, then it will be 150 microjoule. That is our answer.